Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I love conditional formatting in Microsoft Excel. We have a great video today. We're going to take a look at conditional formatting with date fields. Let's go ahead and dive into this video right now. So I have some dates over in column G. Before I start this, just so you know this, if you want to know what today's date is, control semicolon will return today's date for you. If you want to return today's date and it always be updated when you open up the Excel file, that would be an Excel function, the today function. It is equals today, open and close parenth. Tomorrow when I open this file, it'll say the 10th in cell L3. It'll still be July 9th in cell L2. All right. We're going to need the today function for this exercise. That's why I showed you this first. First little tip, I'm going to highlight all my dates and use some conditional formatting. It is on the Home tab, Conditional Formatting, Highlight Cells, Rules. You actually have a date occurring already built in. So I just want to take a quick look at what's already in here for you. Yesterday, today, tomorrow, in the next 7 days, last week, this week, cool stuff is in here. I'm going to use one just to cover this. I want to say what has been happening today. Click OK, and you can see that it worked. I could come back in here and also do a date occurring if I wanted to for tomorrow and use a different color, just so you know that if you haven't been using Excel for long, you can come in here and keep writing conditional formatting rules. I'm going to clear these out. Still have them selected. I'm going to do some conditional formatting now using functions. And the reason I would do that is conditional formatting, highlight cells, rules, a date occurring, does not give me what I want to do. So here's one example. I want to see everything from today's date, which happens to be July 9th, forward. So it's not in here. So I'm going to hit cancel, cancel, still got them selected. Let's go and write a new rule for this. Use a formula. What formula do you want to use? I happen to be in cell G2 right now. So I'm going to say equals G2 greater than or equal to. Do you recall that when I typed in the today function earlier, it is T-O-D-A-Y, but you got to put the open and close parentheses after it. So I'm saying G2 is greater than equals today open and close. Format, fill tab, green color works for me. Pick whatever color you want. Hit OK. Hit OK, and there we go. Let's test it. Cell G2, I'm going to make this 621. And the conditional formatting turns off. Undo, Control Z, bringing that back. So that one's working. Still got them highlighted, or I just selected them again. You can also go and make another rule. And I'm gonna use a formula. Actually, I'm gonna cancel, watch this. So I did everything from today forward in green, conditional formatting. Manage rules, I could have wrote a new rule, but I already got this rule here. I'm just going to duplicate the rule just to save you some time. And then now I'm going to edit the rule and say if G2 is less than today. Put it in yellow, orange, I don't care. Let's go with orange. Everything should be either in green or orange, and it is. So there's that one. So here comes a great one now. I want to see what's going on the next 3 days, because notice that column happens to be called ship date. And I want to see 3 days from today what's going on. So conditional formatting, again, I'm going to clear the rules from the entire sheet. Step one, highlight what you want to do. G2 is the first cell selected. We're going to go to new rule. So in this example, I need to look at 3 days from today. I'm going to have to use the AND function. So let me just show you the AND function real quick here. Here's the AND function. I want to know if someone is in GA and they use Google Ads in my example. So equals AND. GA, E2 equals what state? GA, comma. You can continue on with the and F2 equals Google Ads. It is not case sensitive. I should get a true for this because it is true. Crosshairs, autofill, and I'm just going to double click. I could drag. I'll just double click though. Bunch of trues and a bunch of falses. There you go. Test it real quick. I'm going to change California to GA, and it went to true. So there's your and function right here. Get rid of that. Conditional formatting, new rule. So use a formula. What's the formula going to say in here? Equals and, open parenth. I want to know if G2 is greater than today. Remember, today is a function. Always do the open and close. Comma, so here's the second part. I want to know if G2 less than or equal to today plus 3. Yes. So I want to see if G2 is greater than today's date, which is the 10th, the 11th, and the 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th. But if also if it's less than or equal to today plus 3, today plus 3 is the 9th, is going to be the 10th, 11th, and 12th. So I should get the 10th and 11th and 12th highlighted here. Green, I don't care. When I hit OK, the 10th, the 11th, the 12th. Do I have a 713 in here? If not, let's put one in here. I hope it does not go green. It did not. But also the way I wrote that function, I said today, I didn't say greater than or equal to. So if you want today to be included, let's go and edit the function. Conditional formatting, manage rules. I've got them highlighted. What you want to do right here is add an equal symbol. Now 7-9 will be included. Cool tip. Just hit apply over here to see if it worked. Look at cell G2 and I click apply. It did work. And it's still the 9th, the 10th, the 11th, and the 12th. So really it's 4 days now. I love conditional formatting. I hope you can see why I love it. It's an easy way to highlight stuff that you're looking at, stuff you're responsible for. And we use conditional formatting with just the default date options. Then we used conditional formatting with today greater than, today less than, and then we did a between. And I did the between using the and function. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe. If you have any questions, please put them down below. Thank you.